Hey you guys, it's Shay'auna Alexis, and we're gonna go ahead and get started with our Bantu knots on freshly washed hair, and then we can go ahead and get started. Now you can comb and section off your hair, however I'm just grabbing small pieces because I don't plan on wearing my Bantu knots out as a style itself. And you just want to apply a little bit of product. Make sure that your hair is oiled or moisturized in the way that you would usually moisturize it. And then apply that product to make sure that you really get everything nice and ready before you twist your hair. So after you have your twisting technique down, you can go ahead and start to create your Bantu knot. Now I'm just going to zoom in a little bit closer so you guys can see. Okay, when it's time to actually twist, hold the part closest to your head and then take that long strand of hair and just twist it around that part that you're holding. If you think it's too tight, you can always unravel it and start again. Depending on how you do your knots, they will be thicker or taller. Just depends on the technique that you're using. However, you can see on one of my knots that the hair is sticking up. You can just tuck that back under and make sure that is wrapped up. When unraveling your Bantu knots, make sure you're unraveling them in the same direction that you twisted them so it won't cause any tangles or anything. Sometimes it happens, but just try and avoid that if you can. Then after you get done unraveling, you can just separate them with your fingers or you can get a pick and fluff out your curls. And the foam helps for those stray hairs that may not have curled the best. You know, you just want to do a quick little finger curl and then it'll blend right in. So that's our finished product. Don't forget to hit subscribe, like, and share this video, and I'll see you next time. Bye guys.